Hi everyone, I am Father Johnson of New Catholic Mission School, Jhabua. Today, we are going to learn another poem from English core of class 12th from the book Flamingo. And the name of the poem is A Thing of Beauty by John Keats. Now, before we go to the poem, let us see something about the poet John Keats, who lived between the year 1795 to 1821. And he died at a very early age, at the age of 25. He was a romantic poet, and all his literature, his writings could be divided into three categories: poetry, prose, and drama. Now, let us try to understand the poem A Thing of Beauty. What is introduction? The British romantic poet John Keats published his first epic poem, Endymion, in 1818. It is a narrative about the relationship between a goddess and her human lover. The poem is based on the Greek myth of Endymion, the shepherd who falls in love with the moon goddess Selene, whom the poet renames as Cynthia. This extract, A Thing of Beauty, talks of how beautiful things give us pleasure and alleviate suffering and sorrow. So this is the introduction. Now, what is the theme of the poem? Any beautiful object is always treasured in our mind because it provides us eternal and everlasting joy. The happiness that anything beautiful provides never fades into nothingness, but multiplies manifold whenever it returns to our mind. Meaning to say, anything that is beautiful, it always gives us very wonderful feelings, and it always takes us to different realm of happiness, and that's what the poet is trying to discuss in this poem. Now, what is the gist of the poem? John Keats discusses the effect of beauty on the soul. He comments that things of beauty are sources of everlasting joy for human beings. Its importance for man only increases with the passage of time, and it would never fade from memory, nor would its effect ever decrease. By things of beauty, Keats means anything that would help man to attain happiness. It can be a material thing, a well-loved book, a cherished memory, or even a beautiful piece of music. No matter what, they would help us to calm us down and would give peace and happiness to us, enabling us to have a peaceful night's sleep. They are like flowery bands that tie us to the earth and help us to endure and overcome the different problems in life. He urges us to appreciate things of beauty to overcome sadness in life, like despair, gloomy days, lack of noble natures, ill health, etc. Things of natural beauty like the sun, the moon, trees, daffodils, rills, and forests remove the pall of suffering from human spirits. Apart from things of beauty from nature, the poet also feels that the heroic tales and brave deeds of men of courage, as well as great works of literature, are also things of beauty, as they keep inspiring and motivating us to lead better lives. These are an endless fountain of immortal drink showered on humanity from the heavens. Thus, Keats reiterates the fact that effect of beauty is not temporary, but eternal and timeless. Now, so this is the gist of the poem. Now, let us try to discuss the poem verse by verse. A thing of beauty. A thing of beauty is a joy forever. Its loveliness increases, it will never pass into nothingness, but will keep a bower quiet for us, and a sleep full of sweet dreams and health and quiet breathing. Now, I have tried to highlight some difficult words, also with the meaning. What do you mean a bower? Bough means a shady place under the tree. That is called bough. Now, what is the explanation of this? The poet says that beauty stays forever. It never fades away. Rather, it increases with the passing time. The perception of the poet regarding beauty is that it never goes off with the passing time. Rather, it beautifies more and more. For the poet, beauty is like a beautiful shady tree under whose shade all the creatures can sleep peacefully and enjoy good health. Now, in these first four verses, let us also try to analyze the literary device the poet has used. First, what is the rhyme scheme? It is, just let us go back. See, forever, never, keep, sleep, breathing. So this is A, B, B, C. So that is a literary device. A, B, B, C. Next, what is the, now there are also few, this poem is with full of images, figures of speech and other things. Now, what is the figure of speech here? He has used alliteration. What does it mean alliteration? Use of the same sound repeatedly. When the poet uses the same sound repeatedly, that is called alliteration. Now you see there, use of consonant sound at the start of two words which are close in series. Sleep, sweet. Let us go back. See here, sleep and sweet, both S and S, consonants repeatedly used. So that is an alliteration. Next, there is also metaphor. What is metaphor? Metaphor is an indirect comparison. Ba quiet. So this ba has been compared to calmness that we are provided in life. So power quiet is compared to calmness in life. So that is another literary device. Let us go to the next verses. Therefore, on every morrow are we wreathing a flowery band to bind us to the earth, spite of despondence of the inhuman dearth, of noble natures, of the gloomy days, of all the unhealthy and over-darkened ways, made for us for our searching. Yes, in spite of all, some shape of beauty moves away the pall from our dark spirits. Now, once again, let us try to understand the difficult words what I have highlighted. Morrow, what is meaning of morrow? It is short form of tomorrow, the following day. Wreathing, that is surrounding, so encircling. Despondence, that is depressed. Dearth, lack of something, absence of something. Gloomy, it means very sad. Pall, it means dark black curtain. So these are some of the difficult words I highlighted the meaning. Now let us try to understand the meaning of this. The poet says that every day it is a beauty which fills us with the spirits to live. It is a beauty which builds the desire in us to live, though there are sad moments and cruel people around us. So here the poet wants to say that without beauty, the earth will be full of cruel people and sad and gloomy moments. It is the beauty which is created by God, which helps us to remove the sadness from our hearts. So beauty is the only thing which can remove all the bad moments that we go through in our life, whether it be it depressed moments, sadness, or whatever that is not so soothing. So only beauty can alleviate, remove all these moments of sadness and depression. So what are the literary devices the poet has used? Let us see. Again, once again, the rhyme scheme, let us try to discuss. Wreathing. Wreathing, it's, this verse is compared, see there, the previous one, breathing. Next word, wreathing. So C, earth, dearth, D, days, ways, E, all, Paul, F. So the rhyme scheme is C, D, D, E, E, F, F, G. So this is the rhyme scheme. Next one. Now what are the some of the figures of speech the poet has used? Alliteration, again the use of the same consonant repeatedly in order to highlight the importance. Now B in band, band bind, N in noble nature, S in some shape. So all these B, N and S, these consonants have been repeatedly used, and that is why it is called an alliteration. Metaphor, again it is an indirect comparison. Wreathing a flowery band, that is compared to a beautiful thing of our life, binds us to the earth. So again, it is a metaphor. Imagery, what is imagery here? Creating a sensory effect of beautiful things lined up in a string, a flowery band to bind us. Again, it is an image. Now, inversion, let us try to understand what is inversion. Normal order of word is reversed. The order of the word is just exactly reversed. That is called inversion. Are we wreathing a flowery band? Okay, now it could be written, we are wreathing a flowery band. So this is exactly, it is reversed. That is why it is called inversion. Now let us go to the next. Such the sun, the moon, trees old and young, sprouting a shady boon for simple sheep, and such are daffodils, with the green world they live in and clear rills, that for themselves a cooling cover to make, gainst the hot season the mild forest break. Now again the difficult words. Boon, it means it's a blessing. Rills, it means it's a small stream of water. Break, a process of slowing down. That is called, these are the difficult words. Now let us try to understand the meaning of these verses. Here the poet describes the beautiful things which are present on earth. These are the sun, moon, trees, flowers in the form of daffodils, and the rivers. Poet says that all these things are like a blessing bestowed on all the creatures by earth. He further describes that the trees provide us with their shade, flowers with their beauty, and rivers with their coolness during the hot summer. All these are the beauties of nature, which are like a boon for us. So this is the whole, what the poet is trying to discuss in this stanza is that all these things, beauty of nature, they always give us a soothing effect in our life. They remove the sadness in our life, and they always take us to another level of happiness. Now what are the literary devices the poet has used? Let us try to discuss. See here, moon, boon, daffodils, rills, make, break. So the literary device is H-H-I-I-J-J. So this is the literary device. Now again, there is an alliteration, use of consonant sound at the start of the words, like yes here, sprouting shady, simple sheep, cooling covered, C-C, S-S, S-S. So these are the consonants which are repeatedly used. So that is why it is an alliteration. There is an imagery of trees giving shade. Again another image. Now antithesis, there is another antithesis. Opposite words placed together. Old and young, these are all two words which are totally different in meaning. They are opposite. So they are used in together, they are used in order to give more stress. So that is why it is called an antithesis. Next, rich with the sprinkling of fair musk rose blooms, and such too is the grandeur of the dooms. We have imagined for the mighty dead all lovely tales that we have heard or read, an endless fountain of immortal drink pouring unto us from the heaven's brink. Now, some of the word meaning, grandeur, it means high rank of great status. Mighty means very enormous, very powerful. Tales, stories. Immortal, that is never dying, which has no end. Brink, edge. So these are the meaning. Let us try to discuss. The poet further carries on with the description of the more beautiful things present on earth, such as the beautiful musk roses, which have such a nice fragrance. Then he describes the tales of the mighty warriors who laid their lives for their countries or for humanity. He says that these beautiful things are the gifts from God for all of us. They are like a nectar given by God to us, and these are those beauties which are immortal and give us a reason to live on this earth despite having so many sorrows in life. Let us try to discuss the rhyme scheme. Look here, blooms, dooms, dead, red, drink, brink. So this, the rhyme scheme is K-K-L-L-M-M. Again, there is an alliteration, use of the same consonant. Have heard, there is a use of H in have heard. In these words, the consonant H has been repeatedly used. Again, metaphor, immortal drink. It is again comparison. Indirect comparison, immortal drink has been compared to something that is beautiful. Imagery, bushes full of musk roses. So this poem is full of, it's rich with meaning, images, alliteration, metaphor, and it's a beautiful poem that gives us meaning not only for not only from the point of learning something for our exams, but also it also gives us beautiful reflection on our own life as human beings. Whenever we are sad, whenever we are depressed, look at nature, look at the beautiful things in the world. It could be in the form of trees, flowers, sky, moon, even a beautiful book, or the lives of great warriors who have lived a life of who fought like a great warrior. All these lives, all these things are important. They have great importance in our life, and they are all instances of beauty. So beauty, that is why this poem called A Thing of Beauty, it is related to our own life. It always removes, alleviates our sadness and gives us full of happiness. Thank you, students. I hope you enjoyed the video.